One of the most important features of Transcriber is the one that makes it possible to work directly with Final Cut Pro, allowing you to export subtitles synchronized with the video track as if they were text overlays. The flow is very simple. Once the subtitles are ready, click on the Export button. In this window, click on Export to Final Cut Pro. Choose where to save the FCPXML file. Finally, drag the icon of the FCPXML file thus created to Final Cut Pro, or double-click directly on the FCPXML file. This directly opens Final Cut Pro, which asks in which library you want to open the project. Choose the library or create a new one, and at the end you will see the project with the timeline, movie and subtitles attached. You can customize the workflow, though, and now let's see how. Let's go back to the Transcriber project. Click on Document Settings. This window opens with all the settings that can be customized. In this area are all the settings related to the appearance of subtitles and workflow that have to do with Final Cut Pro. Let's focus on the lower part. Here we can change the workflow, which is what happens once the subtitles have been exported. If you select After Exporting, immediately import in Final Cut Pro. Once the FCPXML file is saved, Final Cut Pro will open automatically, and you will no longer need to drag the FCPXML file to the Final Cut Pro icon. However, you can select Export Send directly to Final Cut Pro, which communicates directly with Final Cut Pro, and you no longer need to save the FCPXML file. This solution is certainly the fastest and most efficient. However, we have kept the option of saving the FCPXML file in case you need to open the application on a different computer than the one on which Transcriber is running. At the top of this section, you can customize the appearance of the subtitles by specifying the font, style, and size. You can customize the font color. Add a border, and also specify the border color and thickness. Finally, the byline parameter specifies the distance of the text base from the bottom edge of the frame. The app automatically handles subtitles with one or more lines so that the text is always anchored to this lower boundary. By default, it's 5%, meaning that the base of the text is at the edge of the safe area. This is just about perfect for a video that has to be published on the internet, while, arguably, to comply with more strict television standards, it may be necessary to raise this value to 10%. The effect of subtitles with a 10% base is this. Finally, we would like to remind you that subtitles are imported into Final Cut Pro as titles, so within Final Cut Pro, they can still always be modified either by editing each individual subtitle or by selecting them all and changing the values in the control panel. The changes will be applied to all selected subtitles. That's all for this tutorial. We will explore other, more advanced features and functionality of Transcriber in future tutorials.